It's the Via.
It's the Via Venezia.
Yeah, we're going to talk about it. We haven't talked about it, really done a review of it for years.
Yeah, so I thought, you know, maybe trot this old girl out.
Yeah.
Shine her up.
No, you know what she wants? You know what Kat really wants? Just to show how much my hair has gotten grayer in the last 2 years.
Oh, yeah. I just thought I'd punt one to you, though, Gail. Let's do an easy one. So
yeah, right. That's all I can handle now, right?
So the Via Venezia has been around for a really long time, and yeah. It's had a couple of, like, not only is the Via Venezia, but a lot of people also know it as the Barista.
Barista from Starbucks, yeah.
Okay.
So what's changed on it from the Barista days is the buttons are a little bit different. We have push buttons instead of toggle switches.
Okay.
On off right here. Brew button, steam button. The steam is on. Let's shut that off.
I turned it on so we could steam.
Okay, let's turn that back on.
Get
so steam right there.
Okay.
Drip trays down here. Pressurized portafilter. And let me show you that. 53 millimeter.
Mm-hmm.
And this is firm for a reason, folks. So that when you tamp out the, when you go like this on a knockbox,
yeah,
the basket doesn't come flying out. This is a pressurized portafilter, unlike some of the others that do pressurized basket.
Okay.
It's the portafilter itself. That little nipple in the center there, that's a valve that opens up at the proper pressure and then injects a little bit of air with it, making your crema, whether your grind of the coffee is perfect or not.
Okay.
So you can be a little more flexible with the grind of the coffee.
So it doesn't mean I could use pre-ground if I want, if I don't want to have a grinder?
Pre-ground espresso.
Yeah.
Yeah, to an espresso consistency.
And then if I have a grinder that isn't a great espresso grinder.
Right, one that doesn't go really fine.
Okay.
Then you can get the non-pressurized. We sell the non-pressurized basket for it as well.
And portafilter.
Basket, yeah, portafilter. Yeah.
You use the same basket that you get.
Same basket, and we have a bottomless as well.
Oh, cool.
We sell. So you can get precise. With these two, grinder is important.
Okay.
Very important.
You're starting to get to more traditional.
Yep.
Okay.
Steam arm is on the left-hand side. It is a articulating one with a Panarello on it. This makes foolproof. I mean, you can make foam regardless.
I think that's actually another change, too. I don't know how many, but the Baristas were just a regular wand.
They were just a straight with the one hole
on
the end.
Yeah.
You can't really do that with this. This is how long it is.
Yeah, I guess you get up in there.
Yeah, you'd have to get in its business.
Get
in its business. Stainless steel casing, and it also comes in a powder-coated black.
Okay.
Stainless steel boiler on the inside that's about 8 to 10 ounces. We're not sure. We can't find any stats on it, but it's a stainless steel boiler, which is good.
Mm-hmm.
Fill the water from up here. Pour it right down in, or if you want to actually, you can fill it this way as well. See, we got this going. So you will get a little dripping from the brew head on these machines as they're warming up, and you will, when you ask it to steam,
okay,
you get a little bit too. Ow! Ha! Woohoo!
Careful.
88-ounce water tank right there.
Mm-hmm.
It's a mambo.
It yes,
really
it is
big. Feeds with a hose. So that the water tank comes out that way, too, if you want to fill it that way.
And this is a single boiler, so you're doing your brew and steam separately.
Yeah. So right now, I've got this, the machine is on, and we have the steam button pushed in, as you know, which allows us now to do steam if we want to. And then if we want to brew, we take this off.
Mm-hmm.
And you can cool it down by running water out of here into a pitcher.
Okay.
And that will cool it down. But when this light comes back on the brew side, you're ready to go. You can use it. Let's see, what else have we got going on here? Like I said, Panarello, stainless steel. One of the other features. Okay. You've got this in here like this.
Mm-hmm.
This is your drip tray, and this is supposed to be just for storage of baskets and stuff like that.
Okay.
Comes with a scoop as well. You can actually take this out, which is the drip tray technically, and you can put this on here and look at how much more clearance you got.
Wow.
About an inch more clearance.
Yeah.
So that's kind of a nice feature. I figured that out. My first machine was one of these. And I couldn't find any demitasse cups where I was living at the time.
And so you had to MacGyver it
a
little bit.
I thought, okay, let's do that.
Cool. All right. So let's pause and you can make me a cappuccino, Gail.
Cappuccino, latte, whatever you want.
All right. We'll be right back.
Yeah, you bet. That's your cow.
Meow.
Actually, that's my. I'm the cow person.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to get out the
any condensation?
Condensation, yep.
Okay.
And you can see that articulating out. And this is a 20-ounce frothing pitcher, so not bad. No special technique here.
Because it's got a Panarello, you're just letting it do its thing. Yep. Do its thing, Gail.
Panarello in milk, that's the technique. I will say, you see the seam up in here that where the sleeve attaches to the screw-on part?
Uh-huh.
That's where the air goes in. So if I was to bury that, you wouldn't get as much air in there and not as much foam.
Got it.
Just so you know. FYI. It's starting to get warm. You can't really regulate how much... what you're going to get out of this foam. You can't regulate the foam, really. It is what it is.
As far as the quality. But you can you can regulate the quantity by...
Burying it.
Okay.
You could, yeah.
You can kind of work it in a little bit afterwards, too.
Yes, you can. Absolutely. Okay. Ooh, that's hot.
Oh, we're also... Gonna cool. overflow there, Gal.
Yeah, look at that.
All right, so you're gonna cool it down.
Yep. So what I'm gonna do is take this off,
mm-hmm.
open this up, and it will squirt hot water down in there. The pump's kicking in. This activates the pump.
Okay. So first of all, it's dissipating all of the steam that's built in there.
Yep. Then it's gonna make water. All right, let me show you in the cup. What the heck? All right.
You'll preheat the cup.
So these come out and start turning the water. And then let's work this bad boy in a little bit too. Maybe you can see that. See? Got some bubbles.
Yeah.
But you can work it in.
There we go. Okay, so all of the steam has dissipated and now it's brought some...
When that light comes on, that means it's cooled the boiler down to the point of you can use it.
Let's okay.
see what happens here. Pretty soon that's got to cool down enough. I mean, it's... Doesn't take much on this because it's not a gigantic boiler.
Okay.
Okay, let me go dump that cup.
We'll be right back.
Yep. Okay, so that red light is on, see? That means it's ready to brew.
I'm focusing on the shot, y'all. I'm not looking at any light.
Oh, come on. This machine has no volumetric control, so you turn it off when you get what you need. And these will brew faster regardless of what you do with the pressurized portafilter.
Okay.
It'll brew faster than the conventional 20 to 30.
And you can kind of tweak it by taste by changing your, like, tamp or dosage or whatever. Or if you do have a grinder, I guess you grind, but...
You can, but you're still going to have a faster brew.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Gail!
Yeah, right.
Look! That's so close to art.
Like, hey, that's kind of a half a compliment.
I like it.
So close to
well, art. it's half a Rosetta, right? So you got this one half side here, and then you know, but it looks great.
Yeah, I see it. Thank you.
But how does it taste? Most importantly,
does it have enough coffee?
Yeah, that's really the key.
Mmm, it's perfect proportions. You want to try it? Are you feeling good today?
Mm-hmm.
It's good proportions. Perfect for me, anyway.
Mmm, nice. Yum.
Yeah.
Cool.
I must say, I had a guy call the other day, and I answered the phone in customer service, and mm-hmm. he said, oh, it's you, isn't it, Gail? And I said, yeah, well, it's Gail.
Yeah.
And he says, first off, your tamps are always perfect, and you do wonderful latte. And I go, oh, thank you.
Someone was looking for a little sugar, huh?
That's what I was, and that said, what do you want?
Yeah, cool. All right, so that is the Seiko Via Venezia.
And one other thing is this does not have a three-way solenoid valve, so you are going to have a soupy pup.
Soupy.
That's the nature
Spoon
of it.
Out. Cool.
Or knock it out, hose it out, whatever.
All right, thanks, Gal.
You're welcome.